generous heart. Yes, he does. God loves a generous heart. A generous heart. 'Cause that's a heart like his own heart. That's a heart like his own. What a generous God.
Everybody, welcome to worship today, this Thursday morning. I hope you're all well and keeping safe. I hope you've had a good week of home learning too. Right, let's begin the worship by lighting the candle. Jesus is the light of the world. Shine, Jesus, shine. There we go. So this morning, we're going to continue thinking about generosity, and we're going to think about generosity alongside one of our values, which is humility.
Here is a picture of a trumpet. Have you ever heard of the saying, blowing your own trumpet? What does this mean? Have a quick chat and pause the video to see if you know what that term means.
So, did you work out what blowing your own trumpet means? If someone blows their own trumpet, then they are wanting to share with everyone exactly what they've done. They're quite happy to boast about all the good things that they're doing or show off to everyone and want really everyone to know exactly what they've done so that they receive praise and thanks for doing it. That isn't what humility is. Here's a story for you, which I think Mr. Mead has already shared with you in a previous worship, that shows how generosity and humility can go hand in hand and how important it is to show humility to ensure that your heart is truly generous.
When you give money to help somebody, said Jesus to his disciples, do it quietly, don't make a big deal of it, and definitely don't do what the hypocrites do. When they give to the poor, they parade through the streets, trumpets blasting ahead of them. And the song they're playing is, look at me, I'm so generous. Yes, they'll get their reward, but it won't come from God, for they will have already received it through the praise and admiration of the people that applauded them. Instead, give your money secretly. Do it so secretly that even your left hand will not know what your right hand is doing, and your Father in heaven, who sees everything you secretly do, will reward you. Then one day, as Jesus sat with his disciples outside the temple, something happened to prove the point. Do you see those men putting their money into the temple treasury box? Asked Jesus. We do, said one of the disciples, and they're giving a lot. The coins rattle and ring as they go into the box. So everyone can hear, said Jesus, and admire those rich men for how generous they are. But look, see, here comes a widow, and she's putting just two coins in the box. And the little couple coins at that, said another disciple, hardly worth anything at all. No wonder you can't hear them drop. It's amazing then, said Jesus, that she ended up giving more than any of those rich men. What? Said the disciples. Impossible. No, said Jesus. Generous, for all those rich men had many more coins in their bags and in their money boxes at home, but she gave all she had, so she gave most of all.
Listen to the story. I want you to think about a couple of key questions. One of them is, which of the people in the story do you think showed the most humility and impressed Jesus the most? Was it the rich man who went about blowing his own trumpet, putting in lots of coins into the pot and making sure that everyone knew what he was doing? Or was it the widow who quietly went about her business and put in a couple of coins that weren't worth a lot of money, but everything that she had? Why do you think that person was the one that impressed the most? I also want you to have a little think about how you might have sometimes gone about your ways of giving and being generous, but actually maybe sometimes haven't shown humility and you've blown your own trumpet and made sure that everybody's known about what you've done. Is there any way that you could have done that differently? Have a little reflect on those now to the quiet music. Thank you. to really think about those questions and think about what a generous heart really is, and to think about how you might have shown generosity but also remaining to be humble at the same time. And I thought it might be quite nice over the week for you to take a heart and inside that heart write up all the different ways that you've been generous but also shown humility at the same time. So gone about your generosity quietly with compassion, because it's what's truly inside your heart. We're now going to sing a new song. Stand up, join in with the dance moves and enjoy. See you in a minute. By saying a prayer together. If you want to say a prayer of your own, that's absolutely fine, you can, or if you want to make my prayer your own, you can say Amen at the end of my prayer. Let's put our hands together and close our eyes. Dear Lord, help us to stay strong and remember that generosity can make the difference to somebody. Remind us to be humble when showing generosity to others and not blowing our own trumpets to ensure that we get the celebration of being generous. Remind us to be generous with our hearts, our minds, our time and our gifts. Even the smallest of gesture can be the biggest gift to somebody else and show immense generosity. Remind us to give what we have and cherish what we're given. Amen. Okay, let's blow the candle out to signal the end of worship. Jesus is the light of the world. No light, no darkness can put out. I hope you all have a lovely day, everybody. There's a song at the end that was playing at the start of worship that you might want to listen to. It's about having a generous heart, and the words, listen to them really, really carefully, and hopefully they'll lift you through the day and remind you what true generosity is. Bye, everybody. See you again soon.
God loves a generous heart, a generous heart. Yes, he does. God loves a generous heart, a generous heart. 'Cause that's a heart like his own heart. That's a heart like his own. Try to keep the more they lack, the more they lack.
what a gift.